Just give me one moment. Yes, we're live on YouTube. You can start, Mr. Bhavan. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. This is Gaurav Sir from Narayana Group. Today we will start with the topic metal and non-metal. Before proceeding to the topic metal and non-metal, first of all, we must know the scene behind the metal and non-metal. These metals and non-metals are basically the classification of element. So first of all, the question arises, what is element? The question arises, what is element? So the topic is metal and non-metal. So basically, what exactly these two terms are, they are derived from the term element. What is element? What is element? It is a substance that is made up of one type of atom. The substance which is basically made up of one type of atoms is called element. So we come across various types of substance in our daily life. Suppose you have a coin in your pocket. You have a wooden block in your at your place, and if happens to fall this coin, we got a very sharp sound. So this substance is told to be sonorous. At the same moment, if we make it fall, it does not produce any sonorous or sharp sound. So this is basically the classification of the element. Something if hit against the ground, it is termed to be metal, and something which does not cause any such sound is said to be non-metal. Now, what is the basic difference between metal and non-metal? First of all, we take the term metal. Metal is an element which is basically electropositive. Before proceeding to its electropositive nature, we can see we have an iron piece. Iron piece shows various properties like iron piece shows various properties like sonorous property, it shows conductivity, it shows malleability. So we can say what are metals, those elements which possesses luster, they are shiny, which are sonorous, which produce sound, which are good conductor, which are good conductor of what? Which are good conductor of heat and electricity. Which are good conductor of heat and electricity are called metals. Electricity are called matter. There are around 118 elements in the whole periodic table, and these 118 elements discovered till today can be classified in three ways. Number one is metal, other one is non-metal, and third one is metallite. So in the whole periodic table, we have around 70% of metals, and rest of them are metalloids and non-metals. So first of all, we must consider what exactly metals are. So we have seen any element, like we have sodium, it has atomic number 11, its configuration is 281, its configuration is 281. Sodium always loses one electron, it becomes sodium positive, so it was 281, so it becomes 28. On the other hand, if we see, we have oxygen, its atomic number is 8, its configuration 26, it gains 2 electrons, it gains 2 electrons, it becomes O2 negative. So here we can see an element is losing the electron and other element is gaining the electron. So will you say this element does not know the significance of electron? If it is not knowing the significance of the electron, that's why it is losing the electron. On the other hand, we can see this oxygen atom is gaining the electron. So will you call it, this is the bagger of electron? It is gaining the electron, so it is devoid of electron. So we can call it a bagger of electron. On the other hand, we can see in the case of sodium, it is losing one electron. So it means it does not estimate the significance of electron, but actually this is not true. Both the elements, as we can see, both the elements, sodium and oxygen, both the elements, sodium elements, sodium and oxygen, these are smart elements. They are actually behaving smartly. You can see in case of sodium, we had 281. In case of oxygen, we have a configuration 26. By losing one electron, it is getting 28 configuration. And by gaining two electrons, it is also getting 28 configuration. So what is the significance of this 8, which is the number of electrons in the outermost shell? So this is all about the concept of stability. Any element has to do nothing with the loss or gain of electron. If it is easier to gain of electron, as in case of oxygen, and if it is easier to lose electron, as in case of sodium, they perform the task accordingly. So the main goal of these elements is actually to gain stability. And what is the criteria of stability? We have the valence shell. In our valence shell, we must have 8 electrons. If it is already having 8 electrons, it has to do nothing with the loss or gain of electron. And if it does not have 8 electrons, it has to gain these 2 electrons, 8 electrons, either by losing the electron or either by gaining the electron. So we can see there can be two possibilities. Either any element is losing the electron or it is gaining the electron. So we can see the element which lose electron is actually metal. So as per the discussion we had right now, we can define the metal is element. The metal is an element which loses electron to gain stability. To gain stability. So this is all about the metal. Now we have the technical definition of the metal in terms of loss of electrons. And we have also mentioned why it is losing the electron. So the main goal of any element, either to gain or lose of electron, is nothing but to gain the stability. And the stability can be obtained in terms of octate. So what is octate? What is octate actually? Octate is attaining 8 electrons. it can be attained by loss or by gain of electron. Now, we are very much clear about the definition of element. This is the exact definition of the element, which is the substance which is made up of identical atoms. And we are also well versed with the definition of metal, which is actually the definition of metal which lose electrons. So anything if lose electron, we can say it is electropositive element. So we are so lucky we have got the new term metal, or we can say electropositive element. We can say electropositive element. Now it is very much obvious, if something is there to gain electron, if something is there to lose electron, so something must also be there to gain electron. If something is there to be entitled as electropositive, so something must be there to be entitled as a electronegative, because we have to make the balance. So here we can see we have metal, which lose electron, which is electropositive, and this metal is a kind of element. So it is very common sense, is the thing of common sense, something is losing electron, so there must be something to gain electron. And that something which gain electron is called non-metal. So if this losing electron species, this losing electron element is entitled as electropositive, so the electron gaining element must be entitled as electronegative. So we are very much clear about the definition of the element in two ways. If any element is losing the electron, it is entitled as metal, and the same element, its counterpart, if gaining the electron, it is entitled as non-metal. And we have given two more terms to this metal, losing electron element or electropositive element. Its counterpart is gaining electron or electronegative element. Now we can see further differences in these two forms. So we can take one by one what is the difference between the metal and the non-metal in various aspects. We can see the difference between the metal and non-metal in physical aspects, in their appearance. So if we see the newly formed iron particle, which is recently prepared, so that this newly formed iron particle is actually shiny in nature. And if you get something which is made up of non-metal, let's suppose we have wooden block and we have a metal block which is of iron. You can see these two things in your daily life. So I'm talking about metal block, and I'm also talking about wooden. So this metal block is very shiny and it is not so. So the very basic difference we can see, if we have anything, we don't know whether it is a metal or non-metal, whether it is gaining or losing electron, we cannot see, we cannot observe this phenomena by our naked eye. So we can see these differences in their appearance. If something is shiny, it is termed as metal. And if it is something is non-shiny, it is little bit dull as compared to the shiny material, it is called non-metal. So if we recap our discussion, so we can see till this slide, I have explained you the definition of element, and we have seen the element as a metal and a non-metal. We have entitled as electron losing species, and we have entitled this element as electron gaining species. Now we have also entitled as electropositive. Electro means basically electron, and positive means this positive term is actually referring to the process of losing. In the same way, this term can be taken as electro, and the gaining process is basically negative element. So here we can see being electropositive and being electronegative has to do nothing with the mathematical aspect. This is not like something is getting added or something is getting subtracted. In the definition of chemistry, if something is losing electron, we entitle it as a positive. If something is gaining electron, we entitle it as a negative. Then after we discuss about the definition in various ways, we took the aspect appearance. If something is shiny, and if something is non-shiny, or we can say dull, if it is shiny, it is called metal. And if it is non-shiny, it is dull in appearance, it is called non-metal. So you can see these differences. So we have made till now the differences in terms of appearance. We can see it is lustrous. This is the technical term, and it is non-lustrous. Now, whatever we are observing here, we are not using any chemical. We are not taking the help of burner. We are just observing these two substances which are put in front of us. So if you are observing something which is put in front of us without the help of any specific instrument, any specific apparatus, in that case, we are observing that substance as its physical properties. Physical properties of any substance is actually something which can be observed, which can be experienced, which can be analyzed with the help of our sense organs. We need not to add any kind of chemical. We need not to take the help of an instrument. In that case, we observe that particular substance in terms of physical property. So as per the definition we have seen, if you are supposed to ask the definition of metal, you can simply say it is electropositive. This is the definition of metal. And this is the definition of metal. You can say it is electronegative. You can say it is electronegative, because these are the very minute observation. You cannot see by the naked eye whether the given element is losing electron or whether the given element is gaining electron. You can just observe these two terms in the laboratory only. And suppose in your kitchen you have the metal piece in front of you, you have the wooden block in front of you. You can see both these things by your eye. You can observe the differentiation between their appearance. So now we can take metal and non-metal. We can make the difference between metal and non-metal on the basis of their physical appearance. So actually here we have come to the point. Now we are in the position to discuss the physical property of the given element. On the basis of their certain trend, their certain parameters, we can define these two elements as metal and non-metal. I hope it is clear to everyone. We are done with the definition. We have taken one or more physical properties. Now we will be considering the physical properties simultaneously of metal and non-metal, because both the properties are quite counterpart of each other. So the first property is being lustrous. Second property is non-lustrous. If something appears to be lustrous, it's called metal. If something appears to be non-lustral, is called non-metal. Now, I told you in the very first or two slides, if something is there, this is the ground surface, this is the ground surface, and in the second case, we have the same scenario. This is also the ground surface, and we have put two unknown substances, which is S1 and S2. It is from the certain height, it is from the certain height. Let us suppose we are taking the height H1, we are also taking in this case the height H1. If we apply a force, this will come to the surface, it will hit the ground, and this substance, this element will also hit the ground. So, if you observe any kind of sharp sound, if we observe any kind of sharp sound, in that case, we can say this is actually metal. And if we don't observe any kind of sharp sound, we can say it is a non-metal. So, sound-producing substance is called sonorous, and which does not produce any kind of sound is called non-sonorous. So in your daily life, you can see in your kitchen, in your room, you have taken anything made up of metal. Suppose you have any apparatus, any substance made up of iron. If we consider this substance S1, and if it is made to hit against the ground, definitely it will produce sound. So it is to be entitled as sonorous. In the second case, the substance, suppose I have taken the rubber ball, or I can take the wooden block, or I can take the carbon solid. If it is made to hit against the ground, it will not produce any sound. So it is termed as non-sonorous, and we will call it non-metal. So we have done with the physical property, which is lustrous. This is the second property, sonorous. It is related to sound. This and this, both are related to sound. One produces sound, this produces sound, and it does not produce any sound when both are hit against the ground. So this is all about the physical property, and I hope you are very much familiar with the metals and non-metals in terms of their physical properties. And we are very much familiar with the definition of metal in terms of transaction of electron. The transaction of electron can take place in two ways only. Either you can gain the electron or you can lose the electron. I have already mentioned something is gaining the electron is termed as non-metal, and if something is losing the electron is termed as metal, and the motive of losing or gaining the electron is same. If you are gaining, the motive is same, which is actually stable. So it is just to have a recap of definition, because we are supposed to be valuable with the definition of electrons, because it's going to help us in the higher classes in terms of chemical reaction. So no one is going to tell you the metal is, we have taken a sodium ion. So no one is going to, in the higher class, it is a metal or non-metal. So you are supposed to be very much familiar with the concept of losing electron and the gaining electron. They are the most common compound we come across in our daily life, which is actually NaCl, and this is called sodium chloride. So you have never imagined before this is standard of it is standard. You have just go to the kitchen and you feel to have something salty, so you just open up the container and take it in your . So we can see this sodium is actually sodium ion, and this chlorine is actually chlorine ion. So we have to do nothing. If something is having positive charge, it means it has lost the electron. Don't get confused with the sign positive. It has to do nothing with the mathematical aspect I have told you earlier. And if something is gaining the electron, it means it has negative charge and it has positive charge. I have told you earlier, something is having positive charge. It is a metal. And something is gaining negative charge. It is a non-metal. So the definition is very much clear, and we have taken the various examples from our daily life. This is not very much new concept to everyone. We just need to analyze these two things which we come across in our daily life from since our childhood. So we have to analyze them via scientific approach, so the mathematical approach, so the, in the definition wise in the chemistry world. Now we take next property, the conductivity, or you can say conductance. If something is, suppose we have taken a rod, I don't know these two rods whether it is of metal or non-metal, which material it is made up of. I can just see two observations. I take rod R1 and R2. I have kept a burner. These are the burners. After some time, if you are touching this end before the burner is kept, after some time, you feel the whole of the surface of this rod get heated. It means if the whole of the surface of this rod get heated, it means it is a metal. Means something is there which is carrying the heat from one end to the other end. And as per my second observation, I can see R2 rod, and I am very much with the same intensity, I am also hitting this rod, and I am touching this rod from this end. And after time, we can say, after the process of heating, if I touch this rod, let us suppose after time t second, I feel no change in the temperature. I don't feel any kind of heat at this end. It means heat is not flowing from one point to another point. So whatever is there, being a vehicle to carry the heat, it is nothing but it is electron. It is actually electron, and electron also there. It also has electron, because electron is the universal particle. We cannot say this rod R1 has electron and this rod R2 does not have electron. It is not so. Electron actually the universal particle. So once both the rods have the electrons, so what is the reason? One point is getting heated. After some time, whole of the rod gets heated. In the second case, it is getting heated where it is burned. So the reason being here, rod R1 has free electron. Rod R1 has free electron, and rod R2 does not have free electron. We can say it has bonded electron. So you can see, if we have free electrons, we are capable to heat the rod all over the surface, and we are not capable to heat the rod in another case. So something, if it is capable to flow the heat all over the surface of the given substance, we can say we are talking about something which is actually good conductor. And the reason of being good conductor is nothing but the presence of free electron. And it is bad conductor. So the next property, if I tell you, I have two things in my proximity. One is good conductor. And other is bad conductor. So something, if it is good, it means it is capable to make the flow of heat across its surface due to the presence of free electron, and we call it as metal, and we call it as non-metal. So one more new property added to our knowledge bank in terms of metals and non-metals, we can see, first property I discussed, electropositive, electronegative, lustrous, non-lustrous, sonorous, non-sonorous, and last in this discussion, good conductor and bad conductor. If we have to the recap of the slides, we can see we started with the topic metal and non-metal. So I had the definition of element. I shared the definition of element with you. What is element? Something which is made up of one type of atoms. So for the matter of example, we can say we have helium, we have hydrogen, we have oxygen. So these all three are actually elements. Let us suppose I have a container and I say it has oxygen gas. So it means it has only similar type of oxygen atoms. Nothing is there except oxygen atoms. So we can say we have something in this container. Since it is having all the identical atoms, one type of atom, so we can say it is actually element. Now, we proceed with our discussion. What is actually element? Element are classified as metal and non-metal. We can see something, if it is capable to lose electron, we can say it is an electropositive element. Now we try to explain, we try to observe the given element in terms of their physical aspects, which we call physical property in chemistry. We can see the very first parameter in terms of physical property, which is sonorous. Second one is conductivity. Third one is malleability. Lustrous. So now we had the count of elements. There are 180 elements in the periodic table, out of which 70% are metals and rest of them are non-metals and metalloids. We will switch to metal, non-metals and metalloids after we complete the term metal. So we can see in this slide the significance of electrons. You can see in case of sodium, it has one electron, so it is losing electron in order to gain its octet complete. In case of oxygen, it is gaining two electrons, so it acquires eight electrons. So if we see, if you don't know about the transition of electron, what is the purpose of transition of electron? If you just see sodium, it is losing electron. So you will say if it is if it is losing his electron, so you can say it does not know the significance of electron. I told you oxygen gains electron, so you will say it is electron deficient. So it is a beggar, kind of, you can say, devoid of electron. But actually it is not so. I told you both the sodium and oxygen, as per the nature, they have whatever the aspects of their existence given by the nature. Both are acting according to nature and they are acting smartly. What is smartness they are showing? You can see sodium is losing electron. You can see the similarity between the two. It also has eight electrons. It also has eight electrons. So we can say what is the purpose of having 8 electrons? There might be some secret behind it. The secret is nothing but gaining 8 electrons. So wherever the concept you go through in chemistry, the main purpose of something you observe in chemistry in any way, it is just to gain stability. So what is the parameter to gain stability? Except hydrogen and helium, the parameter to gain stability is by attaining 8 electrons. There are certain elements, lithium, beryllium, any element, if it has more than 4 electrons in its valence shell, it has to gain 8 electrons in its outermost orbit. This can be done either by losing electrons or by gaining electrons. So I have written here, metal is an element which loses electron to gain stability. What is there to gain stability? When an element can be entitled to be stable once it is having octet complete. So what is the meaning of octet? Octet, you might have learned in mathematics, oct means 8. Oct means 8. So if it is easy to lose electron, the element loses the electron. If it is easy to gain the electron, the element gains the electron. Now, you can see metal losing electron, we call it electropositive. And the element which is electropositive is entitled to be metal. So we can say an element which is electropositive is entitled to be metal, or electron losing species. So in this slide, you can observe we have discussed about the classification of element as a metal. We added new term which loses electron. We added another term which is called electropositive. The counterpart of losing electron is the gaining electron. The counterpart of being electropositive is being electronegative. So you can see in the classification of element as metal and non-metal in various aspects. If we say something is losing electron, it is actually the definition of metal. And rest of the parameter we have discussed, these are the physical properties. Suppose we have taken a metal block, we have taken a wooden block. If you are capable to see normally anything, if you are capable to observe normally anything, you will see that metal block is shiny and the non-wooden block, which is actually non-metal, is non-shiny, so it is non-metal. Now we can see the next aspect of our discussion. We are the element. I again try to make you understand very clearly. The metal is something which is loose electron. So here we can see electro means electron, positive means loose. It has to do nothing with gain. Be aware of this sign. Positive means loose and negative means gain. Positive means loose, negative means gain. So don't get confused about the positive and negative in chemistry in this topic. I hope you are getting the very basic fundamental behind this, the definition of metal and non-metal. Now we took the same lustrous and non-lustrous. So I told you whatever we discuss without the help of any chemical, whatever you observe without the help of any chemical, any specific place like laboratory, you are just observing the differences in the given object through your sense organs. Their appearance, their touch through your ear by hearing to their sound, the intensity of the sound. The intensity of sound is very high, so it is sonorous. So we can see, I have earlier told you, now we have just recapped this, metal is electropositive and non-metal is electronegative. So I was discussing the topic, physical property. Why we call it physical property? Because we don't need anything like chemical, we don't need any burner, we don't need any specific some material to observe these differences. What we need? One healthy person can make the difference between these two objects. If something is put over a height H1 and other thing is also placed at the same height, if it is made to fall and it hits the ground, we can see The substance S1 makes a sound because of its nature. We don't know why. We can know in the higher classes, but right now we can just observe. It is making sound, so it is sonorous. If it is not making sound, it is non-sonorous. Something which makes sound, it is metal. Something which does not make sound, it is non-metal. For example, I have taken iron, and here I have taken wooden block. It is not necessary to take always wooden block. You can say carbon black, carbon solid. You can take. So you will observe the same results in case of carbon or in case of wooden block. Now the question arises, what is there in negative and positive? I have told you in the earlier slides, negative means gaining electron, positive means losing electron. So whatever the element is doing, whether it is gaining electron, losing electron, it has to do nothing but it has to attain stability. What is there to gain stability? You have to attain just 8 electrons, nothing else. In the daily life, I have taken the example NaCl. Everyone is familiar with the NaCl. So in NaCl, you can see if you go to the laboratory and you heat this NaCl or you dissolve NaCl, you will find the NaCl get dissociated into two different separate ions. One is positive ion and other one is negative ion. Same thing. The positive has to do nothing with something gaining. It is just to lose. And I have told you earlier, if something is losing the electron, it is metal. If something is gaining the electron, is it non-metal? It is something is element actually. So we can say if an element is losing the electron, it is a metal. If element is gaining the electron, it is a non-metal. Now we try to cover the next aspect of metal and non-metal in terms of their conductivity. We try to testify two rods. We burn them with the same of two different burners. With the help of two different burners, we can observe after a particular period of time, R1 becomes heated all over the surface, R2 does not. It means the main vehicle responsible for the overall heating up of this R1 is the presence of free electron. You cannot say ki R2 does not have electron. You cannot say this. Both have the electron, but one has free electron and other one has bonded electron. Moreover, you can see if you have a pack, if it is bonded through its chain something, so it is a bad conductor. It cannot move from its surface, from its position, P1 to P2. If something can move, so it has free electron. So we can see again, good conductor, which is capable to get heated up, and bad conductor, which is not capable to get heated up, because in this case, we have free electron. In this case, we does not have free electron. So I hope you are getting the basic difference, basic definition, and the physical property. So from the first to last slide, we discussed the same thing here. Something if losing electron gets positive, something is gaining electron is negative. If it is losing electron, it becomes metal. If it is gaining electron, it becomes non-metal. And the concept of conductor, being conductor, good conductor and bad conductor, we have discussed in the second last slide. So in the first slide, we took electropositive, electronegative. Then we observed their appearance in terms of lustres, being non-lustres. Then we took sonorous, non-sonorous. Then we took finally good conductor and bad conductor. So this is the brief introduction about the metals and non-metals. These are the four parameters. And being positive and being negative is actually the basic definition. So if we call definition, so you can call electron lost, or you can call electron gain. Once electron lost, it is called metal. And electron gain, it is called non-metal. So we wind up our lecture here only. Thank you everyone for joining us. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Students watching online, kindly note that the Narayana Group has foundational courses, both courses from class 8 onwards. Please follow the link in the description below. This is for students watching on YouTube. Please follow the link in the description below and kindly register. Thank you.